Tally ho, chaps. Today I bring you a rather fine example of British engineering. It is none other than the British Lancaster bomber, along with no less than three of its marvelous ingenious variants. Well, actually, two ingenious marvelous variants, and one rather simple white paint job.
Hope you liked that alternative intro I did there. It's the first time I've ever edited a video before, so I was pretty pleased how it came out. But anyway, now to build the Lancaster. So the first thing we're going to do is clear the weather. Okay, right. So the first part of this Lancaster is going to be a 21 block line. So just go ahead and do that. And it's going to be 2 blocks thick. I think I miscounted there. Right, I think that's 21. Okay. So anyway, at the front, we're going to go one block down, and then two blocks out like this. And then underneath this extension, slabs like that. And then here, we're going to place a two block wide line of 11 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, here we're going to go up half a block and then place 7 slabs. And of course it's going to be 2 blocks wide. Before finally going up half a block again, and this time placing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks like that. Hang on, I really have overcounted that. Yeah, okay, sorry. There we go, that's correct. So 4 blocks at the back. Then just fill in this gap. Right. Now to install the glass panes on the turrets and stuff. So the first turret, the forward turret, is going to be 4 glass panes, simply like that. Then the bomber aimers place is going to be 2 glass panes. The cab's going to be 2 glass panes, and then 6 normal glass blocks, followed by another 2 glass panes. After the cab, just build slabs the whole length of the fuselage, like this. And then the back, 2 glass blocks for the rear turret. 6 blocks away from the back of the cab here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, place slabs on top of the existing slabs like this, and then steps behind, because here we're going to have the centre turret, the dorsal turret. I think I'm speaking too fast, aren't I?
I will slow down.
That's low enough for you? Okay, so the what am I doing now? Yes, the rear tail wing, that's what I'm making. It's at that height, so 1 block above the bottom of the fuselage at the end there, and at its widest point it's 3 blocks wide. So just extend it 2 blocks out, then go 1 block in, and it's a, I'm talking too fast again, it's a 2x2 slab square. Then here for the tail, It's 6 normal blocks, followed by steps on top and below. Obviously, same for the other side. Okay, now for the main wing. So you're going to go to the very back of the cab here, of these glass panes, count one block down, and then place upside down steps like that. Then a solid block, steps, slab. Then extend this slab so it's 6 blocks out in total, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then make the steps 7 blocks out in total. Here, for the upside down steps, extend it 5 blocks out in total, making this last these last steps here, turn a corner and go round like that. Fill this in with solid blocks. Then extend the wing from here a further 3 slabs before going in by 1 and placing 3 slabs like this. Then just filling in this. Then we're going to go up half a slab and half a block here, and then go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks, and then count in a block and then put another 5. Then double back so it's 2 blocks thick, this end bit, all the way, and fill in this last bit. So, for the engines, they're going to be 2 blocks away from the fuselage, so break this these steps here and place a solid block and then another solid block and then another solid block. Then 3 blocks away, 2 more solid blocks. Under here, add another 2 solid blocks and then steps like that. Then slabs all the way along the bottom. For this engine, we're going slabs, then 5 solid blocks, then slabs at the end. The propellers are the standard shape, but what I should have explained earlier, we're using this darker glass because this is a night bomber, right? So you're probably going to want to use it on a night map, in which case you don't want glass like this sticking out like a sore thumb. So I've just used a darker shade of glass to go with the general night bomber theme. Then obviously same for the other side with the wing. Rain. It's the one annoying thing about single player, it rains too much. Okay, so that's the structural side of the Lancaster done. Now just to put some banners on. Right, so if you want to make your own custom three banner letter combination, there's a link in the description below, and that will take you straight to a tutorial on how to make every single letter in the alphabet on Minecraft banners. But if you want to follow my combination, just keep watching. So we're going to make a B first. And then an O. Count one block away from the end of the wing here and place a B and an O, and then count two blocks away and place your last letter, another B. The reason we've left this gap here is they would have had a Royal Air Force round all that, but what with this being Minecraft, there's no way I can make it, which is really unfortunate, but anyway, we'll live, I think. For this side, when you're placing your letters, it's start off two blocks before this tail wing here. So it's a B and an O and another B again, which spells out, funnily enough, Bob, which is pretty cool. Bob the Lancaster. Right, but anyway, so we're now going to go on and build the modifications of the Lancaster, namely the Dam Busters Bouncing Bomb, the Grand Slam Earthquake Bomb, and the Coastal Command Spotter Aircraft. So, yeah. Okay, so let's do the Bouncing Bomb first. To when they fitted the bomb, to counterbalance it, they removed the dorsal turret here. So we're just gonna simply go ahead and destroy this, and without a trace it will disappear like magic. Now, in real life, to fit the bomb to the bottom of the fuselage, they removed the bomb bay doors, so that's gonna be our next move. Apart from these two blocks here, just remove all these to the point where it's in line with the front of the wing. Then line this with slabs along the top here, and then finally two steps at the end like that. The supports for the bomb are next, and they're going to go here, 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 and here. Before we finally add our bomb. And there we go, the Dam Busters. Oh wait, I almost forgot. If you're one for historical accuracy, you probably want to remove our Bob title and replace it with something like this, AJG, which is one of the actual Lancasters used on the raid. But conversely, if you don't care, then obviously don't bother. Moving on to the Earthquake Bomb next. Much like our Dam Busters Bouncing Bomb Lancaster, the Earthquake Bomb Lancaster also had its dorsal turret removed. It also had, though, its front turret removed. So we're just going to remove these glass panes here and replace them with steps, like that. And again, like the Dam Busters Lancaster, it also had its bomb bay doors removed to fit this exceptionally large bomb. So we're going to do what we did on the Lancaster, which is remove all these blocks up to the point of the wing there and over there like that. But we're not going to place slabs or anything like that, just leave it and build the bomb. The end of the bomb here is going to look like this. So just steps all the way around, then slabs, then more steps, this time it's a line of three. And And finally, more slabs at the front. And that's our earthquake bomb Lancaster done. Next up is the Coastal Command Lancaster. Okay, so with our basic Lancaster here now, it's time to start modifying it. The Lancaster we're building that was in Coastal Command is the Mark 7, and for some reason the Mark 7 has its turret moved, its dorsal turret here. So we're just going to move this turret two blocks forward, like this. But it also doesn't have the steps behind it like that, it's just a 2x2 solid block square. The other modification they made was this sort of bubble on the bottom of the aircraft here, like that. I'm not quite sure, I don't know if it housed radio equipment or something, but I think it was used for spotting ships. Well, that's a guess anyway. And that's really it for structural modifications, but we'll quickly go ahead and make some banners for this. So as you know already, you can go for your own custom banner combination, or you can go for mine. Mine being, well, we're going to make a G first. So just get the web page there. Okay. G, and then we're going to make an I. And then a T. Yep, you've probably already guessed what this is. It is Git. Why did I do this? Because I can, and it's funny. So anyway, as with the rest of the Lancasters, count one block away from the end of the wing here, and then a G, then an I, two blocks away, the T, and over here, two blocks away from the tail, G, I, T. Wait, no, wait. No, it goes like this. G-I-T. Yes, I think that's it. Anyway, yep. That's not it yet though. We're going to add some special white banners, which I didn't think of until this last Lancaster. So you can do this for the rest of the Lancasters, and that's simply adding the little French flag on the tails. So let's just go and do that quickly. We're going to craft a French flag, so like that, pretty simple. But we're then going to halve it like this. Now we've also got to make a second copy of this, which is basically a mirror of it, so let's just do that quickly. Because the red bit on the French flag always goes on the front of the tail. So let's see if that works. Yeah, I didn't actually try this before. It looks alright. So you can, if you like, add it. And basically just do a black banner version of what we've done here for the Night Bomber Lancasters. There we go. And that concludes our tutorial. Thanks for watching. As always, I'm going to ask you to please leave a like or subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in whatever video I make next.